So this week I started reading a new book, and it was given to me by the lovely Miss Martini. So big shout out to her, because she said it was really good. And she gave it to me yesterday. This book is called The Tattooist of Auschwitz. Auschwitz was a concentration camp, and I read 50 pages last night, guys. It is so good already. Probably a little too old for you guys, but I'm just sharing with you that I have started to read this and I'm loving it, all right? Huge quarantine reader right now, huge. I also officially started what I showed you guys last week, which is the Michelle Obama, our last president's wife, Michelle Obama, her biography called Becoming. So I'm probably about 50 pages into that as well. I'm kind of swapping back and forth between the two. So I just wanted to share with you each week the books that I'm reading, because you know I love reading and I really hope you guys are reading. Last week we had poems that we were working with. We were working with poetry. So stanzas are in poetry. What is a stanza? Well, a stanza is just a paragraph, but it's a poem paragraph. So we don't indent a paragraph with a poem, okay? We just have a line in between, a blank space in between each stanza, okay? So I only had one of you get that correct, and it was the lovely and always participating since we've gotten out, Avonlea again. So Avonlea, you are killing it. Great job. I also had a burpees challenge. I told you guys I was doing 100 burpees a day for 30 days. Today will be day 20. And I said, if you do one burpee, get mom, dad, grandma, grandpa to send me a video of you doing that burpee, I would shout you out. I only had 2 people do this, and it was all for my homework. So, first thing, Danielle Johnson, she not only sent me a video of her doing one burpee, she sent me a video of her doing 4 burpees in a row. So Danielle, fantastic, super athletic looking, awesome job. And Devin Wade, I saw his beautiful burpee as well that his mom sent me, looked awesome. So Devin, continue participating, you're doing great. So this week's text, we had recipes, we had directions, we had schedules, okay? And I know I have it behind me, but what genre are all of those? Functional text. What is functional text? Let's see. Functional text is text that helps us to function in our everyday life. Things we can use to function in our everyday life. I have been cooking a lot, so I've been using functional text extremely often, because what is a functional text? Recipes. So I've been reading a lot of functional text because I've been cooking and using recipes. Let's see some examples of functional text. So I've written 3 examples. The first example is recipes, okay? The second example, directions, okay? When you even read with your iPhone, if you ever have put on the maps in your iPhone and you're reading the directions from there, you're reading functional text. You all are familiar with it. And I put ads, okay? Think about commercials when they have text that shows and tells you what they're advertising, okay? They're trying to persuade you to buy something or do something. So that's another version of functional text. Monday, your directions were, read the label Bugs Away. Use the text to answer each question. Write the answer on a separate sheet of paper. Be sure to write your answers in complete sentences. So you guys should have read this and answered the questions. Number 1 question, how long does Bugs Away repellent keep insects away? Well, I looked right here in the top and it says it keeps away insects for up to 2 hours. So that is our answer for number 1. Number 2, at what distance should you hold it before spraying? So I continued to read down, and of course I read it once, then I looked at the questions, and what do good readers do? I hope you said reread. I reread it to answer the question. So, number two, at what distance should you hold it before spraying? All right, so I continued to look and it says directions, applying to body. It says that you should hold it about 8 inches from your skin or clothing before you spray. So that's the answer for number two. Number three, third question. Which word in the warning section of the label means discomfort? Automatically, I know right now that I need to reread what section? The warning section. So I went down here, I reread the warning section, and I found out that a synonym same, a word that has a synonym for discomfort in this section was irritation. In the warning section, the word irritation means the same as discomfort. Think about when you're irritated about something, if your little brother's irritating you, if your teacher was irritating you, because I know that happens. You are uncomfortable because of it. So discomfort and irritation, they're synonyms, and synonyms are the same meaning, okay? Then for the end of day one, you had to write your own label for using sunscreen. You had to include a directions heading and a warnings heading. I'm not going to give you an answer for this, but if you want me to look at yours, you can email it to me. I have posted my answer key again in Google Classroom for you all, so I hope you're looking at the answer key as you're watching this video, okay? All right, we're moving to Tuesday. Tuesday, read the flyer Toy World. Use the text to answer each question. Write on a separate sheet of paper and be sure to write your answers in complete sentences. So, we did bugs away. Now you all should have moved to Toy World, okay? This is a flyer. So you should have read it once, you should have looked at the questions, and then you should have reread. So number one question, what is the original price for the MP3 player? Easy peasy lemon squeezy, guys. You look to the MP3 player, I have the sale price, but below it says it was, what's that price? $49.99, okay? So the original price of the MP3 player was $49.99. Number two, will all stores have the same DVD movie selection? Okay, how do you know? So the first thing I did was went and reread the DVD section, all right? And I realized that once I reread, it says here on the bottom that selections may vary by store, which means selections are different based on what store you're at. So, no, all stores do not have the same DVD selection. I know this because it says selections may vary by store. All right, moving on to question number three for Tuesday. Which games are included for buy one, get one free? So I reread the buy one, get one free section where it says the games. Tic-tac-toe, bingo, checkers, chess, and marbles are all included for buy one, get one free. After you answered those three questions in your beautiful complete sentences, you should have created your own flyer for a store selling three of your favorite toys, okay? You had to include the original and the sale prices, okay? Again, I'm not gonna give you an answer for that. If you want to send me what you came up with for that to my email, that is awesome, all right? All right, rolling right along to Wednesday. Wednesday, we had to look at the nutritional facts for whole milk and skim milk, all right? Nutritional facts are telling us what are the ingredients in the milk that provide you with nutrition, all right? So you had to create a Venn diagram comparing the two labels. So again, in my Word document that I've posted in my Google Classroom, I could not insert a Venn diagram, so I used a chart. You can look at that for your answers. They are posted in Google Classroom. Then you had to write about which milk is healthier for you and why. You had to use the nutritional facts to support your opinion. Again, short answer, I am not going to give you an answer for this, but if you want to email it to me, my email's on the answer key. Moving along to day 4. We were told to read the Pizza English Muffins and create 3 questions that could be answered from reading the recipe. So the way I did this was I read through the recipe and then I kind of looked and said, what would be interesting questions for students or someone else to be able to answer after they've read this, okay? So I reread and I came up with these 3 questions. Which ingredients do you need for Pizza English Muffins? Need being a key word, because some of them are listed as optional. Number 2, what parts of the directions do you need an adult for? Okay, so you would have to go and look and find, when do you need an adult? And then the last question I came up with was, to what temperature should you preheat the oven? Okay, all 3 of those questions are posted on my answer key in Google Classroom. The short answer for Thursday was to come up with a recipe for a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Seems kind of simple, but you can include any ingredients. So you had to include an ingredient heading and a directions heading. All right, I'm not gonna give you that. If you wanna send it to me to my email is in this answer key on Google Classroom. And yay, today, what did you have to do today? Read the Glenview Elementary soccer schedule. Okay, and you had to answer 3 questions. So we're gonna go through those. So number 1, you had to answer, how many different opponents are there in all? So this was tricky. Why was this tricky? This was tricky because we have how many games total? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have 11 games total, but some of them are the same teams. So I had to go through and look and see how many opponents there were, and I could not repeat the same opponent. So there are 6 different opponents in all, all right? So if you look, we have the Scorpions, the Lions, the Tigers, the Bears, the Dragons, all right? And the Sharks, so 6 in all. The second question you had to answer, what is the earliest time and the latest time that the games can begin? So I looked at the times and I found that the earliest time a game can begin is at 4 p.m. and the latest time that a game can begin is at 5:30 p.m. Okay? And our last question, number 3, was how many away games will the Wolves play? So what you should have done was gone in, looked at the location, all right? And you had to look at if the Wolves were playing. So we have the Wolves and Lions, and that's home, so that doesn't count. We have the Sharks and Dragons, and Wolves and Bears, home, doesn't count. Wolves and Scorpions, home, doesn't count. Wolves and Tigers, oh, that's away, so that's 1-1. Let's keep going. The Wolves and Dragons is away as well. So how many away games is that? For the Wolves, 2 away games. Okay, so that's your answer for the last question for Friday. Your short answer for Friday was to create a schedule for a sport or activity that you like to do. Can you think of another example of functional text besides recipe directions and an advertisement? Here's my challenge 2. For Friday, you had to create a schedule for a sport or activity that you like to do. What sport would I have chosen to create a schedule for? How well do you know me? It's the sport I played in college, hint, hint. All right, guys, so I will see you next Friday with my next YouTube video. If you have to come and pick up a Chromebook, I will see you at Bayview with a mask and gloves, and I hope that you have a mask on too, all right? I love you all, and I miss you all every single day. Please do not hesitate to reach out. Bye, guys. Have a good weekend.